just anyway, welcome to Durgasoft and welcome to Python sessions. Sir, now in this session, just I'm going to talk about the things what you people should aware. Sir, to learn Python, what is the prerequisite? Next, and after that, is the Python the very difficult or very easy programming language? These kind of things we are going to discuss. Okay, next, what syllabus we are going to cover? Next, the basic idea about the basic introduction about the Python by default we are going to discuss, sir, so that you people can get a bit clarity about this one. Sir, can you tell what is Python? Yes, man. What is Python? Yes, Alok, there is in your chart window, there is one column is there named with the questions. Okay, can you please cross check? Yes, sir, there is one chart window is there. So there you can type automatically. I can able to see all the remaining people just start typing. I can able to see. Can you please cross check? Yes, sir. What is Python? can you spell out what is the Python? Yes, man. Yes. So don't tell Python is one big snake. Snake itself is the Python. Sir, Python is a general purpose high level programming language. Remember this one, sir. Python is a general purpose high level programming language. General purpose high level programming language is the Python. Remember that, sir. Now can you just take a bit very special care? High level programming language means, do you know we can able to communicate, we can, sir, programmer understandable language. It is not a mission understandable language. Remember that, sir. Sir, in the olden days, we have mission language is there. I mean, assembly language is there. Like, so those things are low level programming languages. The languages where you have to write in terms of zeros and ones, binary code. Next, and after that, in terms of mnemonics like assembly language, these kind of things are by default considered low level programming languages. Sir, if you can able to read the program, if the programmer understandable, programmer readable, such type of languages are by people considered high level programming language. Are you getting that? So Python is a general purpose. Python is a general purpose high level programming language. Okay, make sure, sir. Sir, can you give any other example for high level programming languages? Any other example for high level programming languages? Yes, good. Sir, Java itself is high level programming language. C language, C++, are you getting? So these are high level programming languages only, because yes, C# like high level programming languages only, because the reason here, sir, these are things of programmer understandable terminology. Okay, not mission understandable form. So these are high level programming languages should be converted. High level programming languages should be converted into mission level. Are you getting that? Should be converted into mission level, then the mission can able to understand, right? Maybe by using compilers, maybe by using interpreters. These are things that should require to convert into mission level, then the mission can able to understand. Okay, like, so programmer understandable languages are by default considered as high level programming languages. So Python is a general purpose high level programming language. Remember that, sir. Sir, now already C is there, Java is there, C++ is there. Sir, is there any specialty for Python? Yes, make sure, sir. Make sure the most easiest programming language, as of now, you can consider Python programming language, right? Remember this one, sir. The most easiest programming language when compared with that bloody Java language, C language, C++, C#, when compared with all these programming languages, Python is the most easiest programming language. Remember that, sir. Sir, in India, in CBSE syllabus, sir, do you know, in India, in CBSE syllabus, already Python came, sir. Sir, school level only, Python came, okay? That much easy programming language is, sir, Python programming language. Have you ever heard, if you want to learn programming, first, which language is the recommended? Sir, generally, somewhere you may heard, sir, I want to learn programming. Sir, first better to go for some language. Yes, Can you please respond each and every person? Yes, which language is the recommended, sir? In you may hard, sir. Highly recommended. First, better to go for C. Better to go for C language because C language is the mother tongue for all programming languages. Once you know C, then you can able to understand the remaining languages very easily. Like you may hard. Correct, right? Okay, sir. That statement 100% pakka wrong statement, sir. Remember that. So the easiest programming language, if you start the programming, is sir, do you know which language is Python programming language only? Sir, why that much easy? Can you please explain with an example? You may ask, and just within a minute I will show. Don't worry about that. So the people, sir, if you want to start your programming, then happily your first programming language, sir, to start your programming, Python itself is the excellent choice for you people, right? Make sure. Okay, so next, some people may ask, sir, to learn Python, is any other programming knowledge is required or not? Some people may ask, sir, how many people don't know any other programming language? Sir, I don't know any language, right? Anyone there? Can you please respond? Don't be silent. Yes, anyone, can you please respond? Sir, I don't know any programming language. Anyone there? Okay, make sure, sir. Make any programming language. Sir, I don't know any programming language. Yes, make sure the people who don't know any programming language, yes, as your first programming language, happily you can learn Python, man. Okay, so to learn the Python, is there any prerequisite? Is there? Nothing is there, sir. Okay, you can able to read English, right? You can able to read English. That thing is by default more enough to learn the Python language. Remember that. Sir, if you know C language or Java language or C#, then it is added advantage, but it is not mandatory. Remember, I hope you can able to understand my words. Yes, ma'am, you can able to understand my words. Okay, if you know other programming language, then it is added advantage. That's all. It doesn't mean it is a mandatory to learn Python. Sir, to learn Python, nothing is required. Remember that, sir. So, two points are very clear. If any person is asking, what is Python? What is the answer you can able to tell? Okay, respond, man. Why you are silent? If any person is asking what is Python, what is the word you are going to tell? It is a general purpose high level programming language. It is one type of programming language to communicate with the computer. We can use this Python high level programming language general purpose, right? Next, to learn the Python, any prerequisite is there or not? What answer you have to tell? No prerequisites, or nothing is required to learn Python. If you can able to read English, that thing is enough. Remember that. Even, sir, I don't know how to read English, then I can't do anything, man. Remember that. Compulsory, you should aware how to read English statement, then, sir, it is acceptable, sir. That minimum knowledge must be required. Okay, make sure. Next one, after that, who introduced Python? Anyone, can you please tell who is the father of Python? Don't tell Durga, sir. Yes, man. Who introduced it? Yes, good. Who introduced it? Python? Who introduced Python? Python was developed by, sir, full name, just Guido. Just Python was developed by, sir, who developed this one? Guido Van Rossum. Are you getting that? Well, sir, Van Rossum, like a full word, Guido Van Rossum. Sir, Python was developed by this person, sir. Make sure. Who developed this Python? Guido Van Rossum. This person is developed Python in which year, sir? 1989. Okay, remember this, sir. This programming language is the old programming language only, but very unfortunate, these days in India is getting more popular. Are you getting that? Once Python 3 came, then that day onwards, this programming language became, you know, more popular, right? Okay, earlier Python 2, Python 1 is there, but once Python 3.x came in the picture, then it became more and more popular, right? But it's the old programming language only. Sir, who developed Python? Python was developed by Guido Van Rossum, sir, in 1899. While working, do you know, sir, National Research Institute in Netherlands, sir. National Research Institute in Netherlands. Remember this one, sir. So while working at the National Research Institute in Netherlands, this person worked. Okay. So this person, Guido van Rossum, developed Python. So remember this one, sir. Who developed Python? Who is the father of Python? Then what answer you can able to tell is, while working at National Research Institute at Netherlands, sir, this Guido van Rossum was the developer of the Python, sir. Okay, sir, next point here, make sure, sir. But even this language was developed in 1989 only, but officially Python was made available to the public in 1991. Remember this one, sir. So officially, yes, it is official programming language. Anyone is allowed to access, anyone is allowed to use this programming language. When, sir? In 1991. So the official date of birth for Python is February 20th 1991. Remember this one. So who introduced Python? When the Python was developed, when it is available for the public in 1991, February 20th 1991 is the official date of birth for the Python. Everyone can aware? Yes, after this is the clear. So what is python? Next, and after that, who introduced the Python, sir? When the Python came in the picture, remember that, sir. Okay, sir, what is the next thing I have to discuss? Very, very important terminology. Make sure, sir. Sir, do you know Python is a recommended, first programming language for beginners, man. If you want to learn the Python, if you want to learn some programming language, Python is the best choice. What is the reason? Why, sir? Why Python is the best choice for this? Sir, very simple. I want to print a hello world. Remember this one, sir. I want to print a hello world, because in any programming language, sir, the first program is a hello world program. Regarding in any programming language, the first program is a hello world program, right? Sir, I want to print a hello world, sir, in Java. Can you please tell what is the code I have to write? Anyone, can you please tell? In Java, what is the code I have to write? Sir, anyone from Java language? Can you please respond? Anyone from Java? Yo, the people who know basic idea of Java, sir. If you want to print a hello world, sir, do you know how you can able to write, sir? Very simple. We have to write, just observe that, we have to write class test. I have to write a class, some class, and then public static void, public static void, main method string array args. Next term, in the system dot out dot println, sir, hello world, like this I'm taking, sir, hello world, like, sir, this is the Java program to print a hello world, to print a hello world. Now I have to save this program. Let me save this program in D colon Durga classes folder with the test dot Java. Okay, I saved this one, sir, in C D colon Durga classes folder. I saved. Now first what I have to do is I have to compile this code. Are you getting? First what I have to do, sir, I have to compile Java C test dot Java. Are you getting? Sir, Java C test dot Java. Java, like this I'm taking. Sir, Java test I'm taking, sir. Now take a bit very, very special care about this one, Java test. Sir, immediately we are going to get output, sir. So do you know in Java program, okay, if you want to print the hello world, what is the program I have to write? Yes, this is the program I have to write. How many lines of the code is there? Can you please respond? How many lines of the code is there? Hey, are you seeing right? How many lines of the code is there? Seven lines of the code is there. Next, after writing this program, what we have to do, sir? We have to compile. And after that, what we have to do? We have to write. Remember, we have to run. So first compilation and then execution. Now hello world is going to get the chance. Sir, the people who don't know about Java, don't worry at all, sir. In Java, this is the work we have to do to print a hello world. Remember that. Sir, now same thing I want to do in the C language. Regarding same thing I want to do in the C language, right? Sir, anyone, can you please, because most of the people already aware C language, right? Can you please tell? Anyone, can you please tell what is the code I have to take? Yes, this is the code what we have to take. Are you getting that, sir? Instead of that, just let me type on my own. Okay, slash, yeah, ash include. Can you spell out, sir? Ash include. Next time after that, what I have to take? stdio.h. Are you getting ash include? stdio.h. Next time after that, void main. Sir, void main. Next one after that, compulsory we have to write the print of hello world, something like I have to write. Have you observed, right? Sir, how many lines of the code we have to write? Printf. Sir, how many lines of the code we require to write, sir? Have you observed? Sir, oddly 5 lines of the code we require to write. Now I have to compile, I have to run, then the corresponding output by default you are going to get, sir. But now, make sure, sir, in Python, how many lines of the code we require to write to print hello world only? Can you please guess how many lines of the code is required? Only one line. One line is by default more enough. Sir, now can you please observe that there is one ideal Python ideal window is there with me. Just let me open. Python ideal window is there. Just let me open that. Yes. Here you want which one? Hello world, like print of hello world, like I can say, sir, that's a no semicolon, such type of terminology directly. Hello world by default will be printed to the console. Yes, observe that. But the same activity if you want to do in Java, in C language, how many lines of the code we require to write, sir? So Python is a very, very easy programming language when compared with all other programming languages. Remember that, because the reason is you never going to feel that, yes, I'm learning, I'm reading some Python program. Sir, it is a normal English. It is just like reading English, how much easy. Sir, that much easiness is there in the Python man. Sir, the people who are coming from Java, in Java, from Java 9 version onwards, yes, J shell concept came to do that. But that is came last September. But in the Python, this type of support is there from day 1, 1991 onwards. That's why when compared with all other programming languages, learning Python is very, very easy. Remember that, sir. So if you know how to read English, that thing is by default enough, man. Okay, to learn the Python, nothing is there. Sir, I hope everyone can able to understand. Is the Python is the easy programming language or difficult language? Easy programming language or difficult language? Sir, don't tell easy. Very, very easy programming language. Are you getting that? Very easy programming language. Is the Python programming language, right? Okay, make sure, sir. Sir, suppose let me go for another small chota example. Now my requirement is, sir, can you please print? Sir, I want to print the sum of two numbers. Are you getting? I want to print the sum of two numbers, sir. How you can able to do, sir? Just have a look once. I want to write Java program. I want to write a Java program, sir. What I will take is, sir, class test. Assume R class add. Public class add I'm taking. Sir, now what I'm taking here is int a comma b. Just I'm declaring two variables, int variables, right? Sir, a is equal to 10. Next, b is equal to some 20. Next, system dot out dot println. The sum is what I have to write, sir, a plus b. Okay, that's all. Sir, this is the code what I have to write in Java to print the sum of two numbers. Let me save this code, yard.java. Regarding, let me compile this code, Java C, okay, yard.java. Regarding, yard.java. The code compiled fine. Now, Java yard. Regarding, Java yard, like this, right? So the sum 30 by default we are going to get. Can you please observe how many lines of the code what I wrote? Can you spell out, sir, how many lines of the code I wrote? Oddly 10 lines of the code I wrote. But even if you go for C language also, almost more or less same code by default we require to write, sir. Sir, void main. Here I'm taking int int a comma b, int a comma b. Next and after that a is equal to 10, next b is equal to 20, a is equal to 10, b is equal to 20. So now the sum, print f of the sum. Okay, the sum is percentage f. Are you getting the sum is percentage d, something like comma comma a plus b, like this I can take. Are you getting? Sir, this much code I have to write if it is the C language to print a sum of two numbers, right? Okay, like, but in Python, this much nonsense is not required, man. Have you observed? Just declare two variables, sir. A is equal to 10, b is equal to 20, print of okay, the sum, the sum is the sum a plus b. Are you getting? Print of a plus b, the sum is a plus b. That's all the sum that you are going to get, sir. I hope, is it clear? Everyone can aware? Sir, observe that. Is sir, to write the code, Python is the most easiest programming language. The reason is, you may ask, sir, in Java, you took int a comma b, but in Python, you didn't take, where is int a, where is int b, and so on. Sir, in Python, we are not required to use data types. Remember that. We are not required to use data types. It is the int type, it is the float type, it is the double type, such type of terminology. Programmer not required to specify. Based on our provided value, automatically, sir, Python by default is going to consider the type. Such a type of thing is by default considered as, do you know, dynamically typed programming language. Are you getting what is the word, sir? Anyone, can you please spell out? Dynamically typed programming language. Python, the biggest specialty, sir, it is the dynamically typed. We are not required to provide type explicitly. Remember, sir, if I consider, just have a look once, sir. Dynamically typed programming language, right? Sir, if I'm taking a is equal to 10. Legend, a is equal to 10, sir. Sir, I never declared, sir, what is the type of a? Sir, you are providing 10. 10 means what? 10 means what? Int value. Automatically, this a is by default considered, yes. A is by default considered, yes. Int type, sir. Sir, how you can give the guarantee, sir? You people may ask. Very simple, sir. What I will take? A is equal to 10. I'm taking. Sir, can you please observe type of a? What is the type of a? Can you please tell? What is the type of a? Now observe that. Is what is the type, sir? Int type automatically. Is it clear, right? Yes. I never declared as the int. My Python is going to consider automatically the type based on your provided. But in Java, suppose by mistake, a is equal to 10. Compiler will give left and right. Hey, you are taking a is what type? Why you didn't declare? Like, immediately compile time error by default you are going to get, sir. If you want to observe that, if you consider Java C test.java, immediately compile time error by default you are going to get. Okay, such a type of facility not available in other languages, but it's available in Python. Clear? Hey, respond, man. Why you people are silent? Just start using the terminology of Python so that you people can feel more comfortable. So, sir, in Python, is it required to declare the type explicitly? Anyone, can you please tell? Respond. Is it required to declare the type explicitly? No. We are not required to declare the type explicitly based on our provided value. Python automatically consider its value. This type of thing is nothing but dynamically typed programming language. Sir, type will be assigned dynamically. That's why dynamically typed programming language. Remember that. Dynamically typed programming language. Clear? Yes. Up to this. Not required to keep any explanation. Not only this one, sir. You can take anything, no problem at all. Next, suppose here, observe that. Sir, suppose I'm taking b is equal to true, sir. B is equal to true, I'm taking. Now, can you please tell what is the type of b? What is the type of being? Boolean type, Boolean type. In Python, we are not required to declare, sir. Automatically it's going to tell, sir, if you want, observe that I'm taking B is equal to true, sir. B is equal to true. Now have a look once, sir. Type of B. Are getting type of B? B. What is the type of B, sir? Boolean. Remember this one, sir. Boolean. Okay. We are not required to declare the type explicitly. The type will be assigned automatically. This concept is a dynamically typed programming language. Is it the advantage feature to the programmer or not? Hey, our job, Python is going to do automatically, man. Is it advantage feature or not? They respond, why you are silent? Is it advantage feature or not? Yes, definitely this one is big advantage feature, man. Okay, not only this, sir, everywhere, sir, you are going to get n number of benefits in the Python. Sir, suppose here observe that in Java, what I want to take is, have a look once about this terminology, right? Sir, in Java, I want to take, sir, compulsory have to take A and B. I want to assign A is equal to 10. Next and after that, B is equal to 20. Like this. How many lines of the code I wrote, sir? Have you observed? Sir, 3 lines of the code I wrote. Of course, just here up to this consider. How many lines of the code I wrote, sir? Three lines of the code I wrote. Okay. Just to assign A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20, like this, right? But in Python, do you know how many lines of the code is required? So the biggest facility here, observe that A, B is equal to 10, 20. Are you getting A, B is equal to 10, 20. Sir, now here observe 10 will become the value of A and 20 will become the value of B. Are you getting? We are not required to write so big lines of the group first to declare, and then what is the A value, and then what is the B value, and so on. Suppose 4 variables are there, sir. A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D is equal to 10, 20, here have you observed 10, 20, 30, 40. Okay, just take a bit special care, sir. How many values are available? How many variables are there? 4 variables, sir. Sir, I want to print the value of A, the value of B, the value of C, the value of D. Sir, in other languages, do you know, print of A, next, like there is some way. But in Python, do you know, print of A, B, C, D, that's all. Are you getting? With the comma separation, any number of values you can able to print, man. Automatically, all these values by default are going to come in the picture. Are you in a position to understand, right? Just have a look once. I'm taking A, B, C, D is equal to 10, 20, 30, 40. Are you getting? ABCD is equal to 10, 20, 30, 40. I'm taking, sir. Now, sir, here, print of A, B, C, D. If you can ask this type of print statement in Java, compiler will give left and right. Remember that there is in Java no such type of facility, man. 10, 20, 30, 40, by default, apply it is going to print. Clear? Are you seeing the advantage of Python when compared with other languages, right? Okay, remember. Next, here just have a look once. Another small, chota thing. Observe that, sir. Suppose I declare a variable, sir. I declare one variable. Yes. Why you are always compared with Java? Because most of the times, you know, so after completing the session, usually I have to go for Java class only. That's why. Okay, now listen this one. Sir, now my question is, observe that. Suppose I'm taking int x is equal to 10. Take a bit very special case, sir. Int x is equal to 10. Can you tell what is the x type? I respond. What is the x type? Each and every person, please respond. What is the type of x? At least the people who know programming, Java programming, or any language. Sir, what is the x type? Int type. X type is what type? Int type. Now my question is, throughout life, x is always int only. once we decided the type, sir, it is always what types are intertype only. By mistake, in the next line, I'm taking Boolean value. Is it allowed or not allowed? By mistake, I'm taking in the next line, x is equal to Boolean value. Allowed or not allowed? Not allowed. Compiler will give left and right. Hey. So immediately what the compiler is going to tell, are pagal ho gaya, pagal. So x is declared as the inter time. Why you are taking as the Boolean value? Sir, Boolean value, how you can assign to the inter type? Immediately compile time error by default, we are going to get, sir. Observe a bit very carefully. What is the compile time error? Incompatible types. Boolean cannot be converted to int, sir. But same thing, why don't you ask the Python? why don't you ask the same thing in the Python? A is equal to 10, I'm taking. What is the type of A? Type of A is what types are? Int type. I showed already somewhere. Okay, even the people who don't know, just observe, keep on listening. Automatically at certain point, you will get much clarity. Don't worry about that. Sir, what is the type of A? Inter type. Remember, suppose I'm taking, sir, A is equal to true, sir. A is equal to true. Sir, now, A is what type? Inter type. Now I'm assigning Boolean value to A. True means Boolean type. Boolean value to A. Sir, can I get compile time? Can I get any error or not? Respond in Python. Can I get any error or not? No way. Because, sir, up to this, A is inter type only. But once we assign A is equal to true, now onwards, A is a Boolean type. Are you getting it? Automatically, the type will be changed based on your provided value. My Python never going to keep any objection for me. I will look once here. A is equal to 10. I'm taking A is equal to 10. Sir, what is the type of A? What is the type of A? Inter type. Now, same A, I'm taking true, sir. Are you getting? Same A, I'm taking true, sir. Now, what is the type of A? Now onwards, A is considered the Boolean type. Everyone can aware, sir, we never going to get compile time error. Based on your provided value, automatically the type by default will be considered. Okay, sir, clear? Yes. Okay, that's all. These are various what is the specialty you people should aware, sir. Okay, so like not only here, sir, most of the times, you know, something like in Python statements are something like English statements only. Remember, suppose I want to print 1 to 10. Are you getting? This is about my requirement, sir. If I want to print 1 to 10, so some loop concept is required. Like, what is the way, sir? Anyone, can you please tell what is the way in Java? For int I is equal to 0 or int I is equal to 1, I is less than or equal to 10, I plus plus, next and after that, system dot out dot println of I value, like we have to write like this, correct? But in Python, we are not required to write like this. Are you getting? What I will do is for i in range of, sir, 1 to 11, 1 to 11, for I in range of 1 to 11, 1 to 11, 11 means what? Sir, 11 minus 1, it is internally is going to be considered, sir. What I'm trying to take? Print of I value. That's all. For I in range of 1 to 11, print of i. By default, 1 to 10, the values by default are going to be printed. Are you getting? Sir, is it, have you observed? For i in range of 1 to 11, something like reading English statement. It is not coding. You never going to get the feeling that it is something like coding you are going to get. No, sir, that's all. Everyone can aware? Are you able to understand, right? Okay. Yes, yes, Basuraj. We can able to increment by 2. All the things we can able to do. Don't worry about that. Okay, we will discuss it. Just the sum. Next, suppose I'm taking, sir, x is equal to 10. If for 20 less than 30, else, if for 20 less than 30, else, its value is 50, sir. Just can you please read this one? Can you please read this line? X is equal to 10. If 20 less than 30, else 50, sir. Else 50. Are you feeling it is something like programming language or English statement? What is the value of x? What is the value of x? X. So if 20 less than 30, if 20 less than 30 satisfied, then this is the value. Else man, this is the value, right? So do you know it is the valid code in the Python? It is the valid code in the Python, man. Okay. But the same thing if you want to do in other languages, do you know, sir, some programming code you require to write, but in Python we require to write English statements. So that much easy programming language is the Python programming language, right? Sir, if you want, have a look once whether this one is going to work or not. This type of thing is nothing but conditional operator. Okay, conditional operator. X is equal to, sir, 10. X is equal to 10. If for 10 less than 20, else some 50 I'm taking, sir. Sir, what is the output? What is the output by default you are going to get? What is the x value, sir? Respond. What is the x value? According to this code, what is the x value? 10. Sir, print. If I print x value, 10 by default you are going to get. Are you getting? So seems to be it is not the programming code, programming instruction. See, it is an English language statement only, normal English statement only. That much easy programming language is the Python, sir. Sir, in other languages, if 20 lines, 30 lines, 40 lines are required, but in Python, 2 lines, 3 lines, 4 lines are required. Okay, length of the code is also very, very small. Concise code we can able to write to meet our programming requirements. So that's why if you want to learn the programming as your first programming language, highly recommended you should go for what? Python. Remember that. Okay. Akash Sinha, why we didn't write print? Okay, sir, this is Python IDLE. Sir, this tool is called Python shell. Sir, in the Python shell, we are not required to use print statement. Automatically, it can able to print the corresponding thing, whatever. If you are writing normal Python program, you can write something like Java program, you can able to write a Python program also. Okay, so then you have to write print statement, but here I'm using Python IDLE tool. Are getting? Python IDLE tool. Okay, that's why we are not required to use a print statement. Remember that, sir. All the remaining people also, sir, you are writing some code. Okay, how you can write, how to install and so on, all these things I will take care. Don't worry that much. Okay, just aware, oh, this is the program Python code like this, right? Clear? Okay, yes. If you can write x, that's all. Automatically it is going to print the corresponding value. No, sir, I want to go for program only. How you can able to do that? Very simple. What I'm taking, just a normal, any normal text file you can open. Even your notepad also you can open, no problem, sir. Notepad is there, you can open notepad. What I'm taking, sir, for i in range of 1 to 11, can you please print here I'm taking learning Python is very, very easy. Okay, like I'm taking, sir, learning Python is very easy, and print that i value also. That's all. This is about my code. Can you please tell how many lines of, what is the output I will get now? How many times that print statement is going to be executed? Yes, sir, 10 times. 10 times it is going to be executed. Remember that. Okay, so how you can able to do that, sir? Let me save this code here, test.py. Observe, sir, observe very carefully how I'm saving this code. Dot py, dot py, okay, like a test dot py I'm taking, sir. So save, okay. Now let me open my command prompt, sir. Now if it is a Java program, I saved in this location. If it is a Java program, can you please tell what I have to do? Yes, man, anyone, what I have to do? If it is a Java program, what I have to do? First I have to compile, and after that I have to run. First I have to compile, and after that I have to run. But make sure Python, we are not required to compile, okay? We are not required to compile. It is, yes, sir, directly interpreted programming language. Are you getting it? It is directly interpreted programming language. Directly you can write py test.py. Are you getting what is the command? Earlier we are using Java C, Java test, but now which command you can take? Py test.py. Now observe that. That's all. No compilation, no execution. Only this line is enough, which is going to take care of everything. Yes. Learning Python is very easy. Sir, this is the biggest feature, whatever Python has. We are not required to compile. Directly, we can run. Everyone can aware? Yes? Are you seeing right? So, this is that much easy programming language we are going to learn, sir. That's why. So, if you want to learn Python, sir, you are not required to have any basic idea, easiest programming language. Remember that. Sir, now I have one small doubt, sir. Okay. Sir, why the name Python? Anyone, can you please tell? Why the name Python? The people are always using Python. Why the name Python? Based on which reason? The Python name came in the picture. Yes. Based on which reason? Python name. It is just a normal name. Or any reason for that? Pythagoras. Good. Like your name. Given by your mom. Yes. Any reason for that, sir? Why the name is always Python? Python name came. So just can I use the word, sir? Python is yes. Python is something like what we call a big snake. Python is also that much snake. That's why Python came in the picture. No. Remember that, sir. So in the, do you know 1969 to 1974. Oh, olden days. At that time we didn't burn also, I hope. I'm sure we never we didn't burn at that time. Sir, at that time there is one popular fun show, popular comedy show is there in the BBC channel, sir. Do you know, in Telugu we have Jabardasti. Are you getting Jabardasti Telugu? If any Telugu person is there in this session, Jabardasti show. Next, and after that, even in India also comedy shows are available. What is that? Anyone? Kapil Sharma, like a Kapil Sharma show, like a comedy shows. Okay, so like, do you know, sir, in the BBC there is one there is one show, fun show is there, sir. The name of that show is the complete Monty Python's circus. Are you getting? This is the show name. Sir, this was very popular during that time. Remember that, sir. Very popular during that time. So just it the fun, everyone can like anything. That's why what this Rosham did. Why don't you keep this name? Like Rosham felt like that, Van Rosham, and he used the same name. For this programming language. Don't feel Python is nothing but snake, one type of snake. That's why it came in the picture. No, it is from this comedy show, which was broadcasted in the BBC channel in this year. So that was based on this name, Python came in the picture, right? Okay. Sir, if you want to just in the Google, if you type, then you can able to see. you can able to see several things. Observe that a bit very carefully, sir. One minute. Okay, you can able to see several. Just worry. 1 minute, sir. Something is happening here. Here just observe that. Just can you please have a look once, sir? If you observe the images, you know, all these things are comedy shows. Can you please observe that? Okay, Monty Python's Flying Circus. Okay, like these things are nothing but, you know, sir, like based on these things, sir, this is based on these comedy shows. Are getting the complete Monty Python's Flying Circus based on these things, sir? Just the name Python came in the picture. Beyond that, there is no special reason for that. Clear, right? Next, and after that, now I have one small doubt, sir. Now I have a small doubt, sir. What's my doubt is, Java is the object-oriented programming language or not? Anyone, can you please tell? Java is the object-oriented programming language or not? Yes. C language, not object-oriented. Can I use the word C language here? Functional programming language or not? Yes, procedural, functional programming language. There is one language that's a Perl and shell script. Those things are by default considered as scripting languages. Perl is by default considered as scripting languages, like Perl, JavaScript, shell script. These languages are by default considered scripting languages. Next, there are some Modula 3. It is also one programming language. Sir, this language is by default considered a modular programming language. Are you getting modular programming language, right? Now, there are multiple types of programming languages are there. Object-oriented. Next, and after that, functional programming languages, scripting languages. Next, and after that, modular programming languages, like there are several types are there, sir. Now my question is, Python is which programming language? Anyone, can you please tell? Python is which programming language? Good, Tariq. Python is which programming language? Object-oriented, excellent, Vinay. Sir, both the procedure and object-oriented. Have you ever heard about Python script? Can you please write Python script? Somewhere you may heard about this one. Hey, can you please write a Python script? Okay, somewhere you may heard. Sir, make sure Python is object-oriented programming language. Are you getting? Can you please spell out again? Python is object-oriented programming language. Python is functional programming language. Are you getting? It is a functional programming also, both object-oriented and the functional also. Can you please tell either Python is the scripting language? Python is the scripting language? Yes, man. Is the scripting language? Oh, just I told already Python script. So make sure Python is everything, man. Okay? Python is everything. Okay? It is the object-oriented programming language. It is functional or procedural programming language, scripting language, modular programming language. Python is every programming language, man. Any programming language. Do you know? While developing Python, okay? While developing Python, okay, this Sir Guido developed a Python language by taking almost all programming features from different languages. Remember that, sir. Sir Guido, while developing Python, he borrowed, sir, almost all programming features into Python. Remember this, okay? Sir, now, do you know functional programming language? Functional programming language features from C language. Functional programming language features from C language. So in Python, functional programming features are there. It is borrowed from C language, right? Next and after the object oriented programming language features, object oriented programming language features from C++, from C++. Sir, next scripting language features, scripting language features, scripting language features borrowed from Perl and Shell script, Perl and Shell script, Next, modular programming language, modular programming language features, do you know from modular 3? Are you getting modular 3? While developing Python, remember that, sir, while developing Python, okay? So most of the features, all other language features already added in the Python. That's why Python is the functional programming, Python is object oriented programming, Python is the scripting language, Python is the modular programming language, sir, all in one, okay? Which is nothing but Python, sir. Remember that, okay? Some people are asking, sir, some Java people especially, they are asking, sir, how did the functional programming language, Rishi? Some Java people are asking, how did the functional programming language write? In Java, if it is the OOPS programming language, everything you have to write within the class, you have to create object and so on. Correct, right? If it is the OOP, object-oriented programming language, everything you have to write, okay? But in Python, we are not required to do like that. Sir, observe that. Sir, I'm not taking here, if you observe my previous code, am I writing any class? Am I creating any object? No, just two lines I'm writing. Now I'm asking, hey Python, can you please execute? Two lines I'm writing, can you please, Python, can you please execute like? So without the class, without object, still my program can able to run. Can you please do that? In Java, in Java, this type of terminology? No, are you getting? Sir, same. I'm taking some function, df of which function I'm taking, sir. Df of which function I'm taking. Now I'm using print of. Hello students, good evening. Directly I'm writing a procedure. Are you getting? I'm writing a procedure, sir. Now here just sir, directly I'm writing a function or procedure directly. Now I'm calling this one, that's all. No class, okay, no object, but still write a function. Call that function any number of times. Can you please execute this code? Here, what I'm taking? Sir, py, test.py. Have you observed? Hello students, good evening. Three times it's got executed or not. Okay, make sure, sir. Make sure. Yes, Rishi, I hope your doubt got clarified. Yes, are you getting right? Without writing any class, without creating any object, sir, this type of thing is possible. That's why, sir, simple terminology, you people should aware, okay? It is the Python, sir, functional programming, it is the object-oriented programming, like everything itself is nothing but all in one, it is the Python, sir. Don't worry about that. Next, sir, but most of the syntax in Python, sir, still some people are asking, sir, what is the difference between that language, this language and so on. Don't worry, slowly we will discuss all those things in detail, okay? First, try to get the basic idea first. Sir, the features are borrowed from other languages. Sir, functional programming features coming from C language. OOP features are coming from C++. Scripting language features coming from Perl and Shell script. Modular language features coming from Modular 3, okay? Well, but now most of the syntax, what we are using in Python, derived from C language, and any other language. Most of the syntax in Python derived from C language and ABC language. Are you getting it right? Sir, most of the syntax is derived from C language and the ABC language. Sir, you didn't I never heard ABC. No, sir, ABC programming language is there. Okay, from that, in the olden days, this programming language is there. From that, the syntax is borrowed into Python. ABC is what? ABC is one programming language, man, just like C. Just like C. C is what? What is C? Rakesh. Rakesh, what is the C? C is one programming language. Like ABC is also one programming language, man. Okay? ABC is also one programming language. Official programming language only. Don't feel Durga sir creating some his own word. No, no, no. It is official programming language, man. ABC language is there. Okay? From C language and ABC programming language, yes, most of the syntax is borrowed. Remember that, sir. Sir, up to this is the clear? Ayo, respond. Sir, in the first class only, sir is telling all the syntaxes and so on. Don't feel just my intention is to get some basic idea. Oh, overall picture about this Python. That's about my target, right? Up to this is the clear? Sir, what is Python? Is it good programming language to learn or not? Next, it is all in one or not? Okay. Why the name Python? Next, who introduced this Python? In what year this Python came in the picture? Like all the things you people should aware. Remember that, sir. Next, sir, do you know where we can use this Python? Of course. Sir, what are various, where we can use Python? Okay. Listen this one. Where we can use Python? Like you may ask. Sir, take a bit very, very special case, sir. You can use Python for any kind of thing, man. For any kind of thing, you can able to do that. You can able to do that, sir. For developing desktop applications, for developing desktop applications, desktop applications. I want to develop, sir. Can you please give any example for desktop application? Desktop application, man. So the program, the application, which is going to run on single machine. Single computer, which is nothing but desktop applications, sir. Best example, calculator. Sir, we have calculator is there. Are you getting? We have calculator. Calculator is there, sir. Just observe that. We have calculator is there. Okay. Sir, now I want to use this calculator. Are you getting? I want to use this calculator. Observe that a bit very carefully, sir. So this calculator itself is nothing but one desktop application, sir. Write a Python program to design your own calculator. Yes, we can able to do that. So to develop desktop application, happily we can use Python. Okay. Next, second one, sir. For developing web applications, I want to develop web applications, right? Sir, can you give an example for web application? Web application, anyone, can you please give an example for web application? Sir, anything. Open website. Do you know? Open the browser, send a request, getting the response. Gmail, Facebook, Twitter, all these things are nothing but web applications only. Remember, for developing web applications, happily you can use Python, man. No problem at all. Okay. Sir, next, sir, for developing database applications, if you want to develop database application, yes, we can use Python. Okay. Next, for developing network programming. Are you getting? For developing network programming applications. Okay. We can use Python. Remember that, sir, network programming. Sir, next, for developing games, we can use Python, sir. Developing games, we can use Python. Next, do you know the most important application area for the Python is for data analysis? Are you getting right? For data analysis, okay? Data analysis, compulsory we should go for, sir, Python. Do you know the people who want to learn machine learning, the people who want to learn data science, Python, yeah, deep data mining, yes, deep machine learning, deep learning, like that, sir, Python is the best choice, even when compared with other languages also. Python and R, these languages are best preferable, sir. Remember, next up, for machine learning, okay, happily you can use Python, no problem at all. Next, for developing AI applications, do you know what is the meaning of AI? Respond, what is the meaning of AI? Okay, AI, for AI application, artificial intelligence application, Python is the best choice, right? For IoT, what is that IoT? What is the IoT, sir? Yes, Internet of things, these days very famous word, IoT, internet. Internet of things, sir. Do you know? For that also, Python is the best suitable programming language. Remember that, sir. So Python is the most popular programming language. Make sure, sir, for any type of application we can able to develop. But there is one small myth is there, sir. There is a small myth is there. I mean, say a small limitation is there, sir. So there is, if any person is asking, okay, your Python is the hero. Is your Python having any limitations? Yes, man. There are two areas, sir. As of now, these are two areas. Okay, Python is not up to the mark. One is performance wise. Are you getting? Performance wise, when compared with other languages, performance wise, Python is not in a position to stand in front of them. One thing. Next, for developing mobile applications. So mobile applications. If you want to develop mobile application, then automatically, sir, Python is considering as a secondary language only, but not as the first. First language is always Android. Next and after that, sir, iOS. Have you remembered? iPhone, iOS, Android. These kind of things are best suitable for developing mobile-based applications, right? But anyway, these are the limitations. Just aware these words. Clear? Yes, ma'am. Can I use Python to develop any type of applications or not? Hey, respond. Can I use Python for developing any type of applications or not? Yes. Okay. Remember that, sir. Next, can you please tell some standard application where this Python is already used, sir? Best example, man. Best example, YouTube. Are you getting? Without this, you can't do anything, man. Without this, you can't do anything. For small kid to old person who is going to die also. Without YouTube, we can't. Do you know, right? So my kid is there. Just his age is almost. Do you know, right? My kid age. Do you know? Very just 1.5 year. 1.5 year below 2 years. My kid is telling, I want to see YouTube. Are you getting that? YouTube, like, so, okay, so compulsory, okay, YouTube, okay, this YouTube, okay, video sharing service, right, videos, sir, in this Python user, sir, remember this one, Python user, next one after that, Google, in the Google, Python is there, sir, remember that, okay. So next and after that, okay, Dropbox. Are you getting Dropbox? Dropbox, yeah, I hope you people may heard about this one, Dropbox. Next, sir, BitTorrent. Okay, BitTorrent. Next, NASA. You know NASA? I hope you people may aware BitTorrent. Like, there are multiple organizations already used Python, already using Python, sir. Remember that, sir. Don't fail, sir. Today it came in the market, that's why we are learning. Okay, sir, like, no, okay, this Python itself is nothing but already used by standard organizations only. Internally, Google and YouTube use Python coding, sir. NASA and the network stock exchange applications developed by Python, remember that, sir. Top software companies like Google, Microsoft, IBM, Yahoo using Python. Clear? Everyone can able to understand, right? Yes. Instagram also. Okay? Like that's all, sir. This is just the basic idea. Better to keep in your mind what is Python. Okay? So these are the things just I introduced, right? Sir, what is Python? Anyone, can you please tell what is the Python? Python is a general purpose high level programming language. Who introduced Python, sir? Can you spell out who introduced Python? Guido Van Rossum, sir, while working at National Research Institute in Netherlands, sir, in 1989 the Python was introduced, okay, but officially made available to the general public in 1991. That's why official date of birth for Python is February 20th, 1991, sir. Remember that. Next, when compared with other languages, Python code is very, very easy, sir. Okay, make sure, sir, types we are not required to use. we can write very concise code which may not possible in other languages. Sir, can I use the word Python is dynamically typed programming language or not? I respond, Python is dynamically typed programming language or not? Yes, okay, make sure, sir. Next, sir, do you know this, why the name Python? Why the name Python, sir? The complete Monty Python circus. Okay, this is one famous fun show which was broadcasted in BBC. Based on this name, automatically the Python name came in the picture. Next, Python is object-oriented programming language. Python is functional programming language, object-oriented scripting language, modular. All in one is the Python, sir. But most of the syntax is derived from C language and ABC languages. Next, where you can use Python, sir? For developing desktop applications, for developing web applications, you can use database applications, network applications, like, sir, happily you can use everywhere. But still, there are some limitations. Maybe overcome, don't worry at all, sir. May overcome. One is performance wise there is some issue. Next, for mobile application, Python still it is not considerable language, because Android and iOS, those are dominating mobile area. Next, and after that, almost standard organizations already used Python. Remember that, sir, already used Python, right? Clear? I hope. Are you getting basic idea? What is the Python? Respond. What is the Python? Are you getting basic idea, right? Okay, that's all. Next, do you know, every day we are going to discuss almost, sir, 1 to 1.5 hours. Almost 1 to 1.5 hour, the class will be there, sir. Almost around 2 months, the class duration by default will be there. Almost around 2 months. 2 months, the class duration is there. Next, after completing everyday class, our team is going to share, sir, video recording. Video recording, sir, will be shared. So happily, even you are missing a class, or otherwise, if there is any doubt to refer, happily you can able to refer these videos multiple times, so that you will get much clarity about these things. Next, sir, for every topic, whatever I'm discussing, we are going to provide clear material, sir. Sir, you are going to get chapter wise material. Don't worry at all. Okay, clear material we are going to provide in the form of PDF. You can download, you can take the printout, and happily you can prefer. Sir, is there any material is there in the Python? Have you observed, right, sir? This is just, we will share these type of things, so don't worry about that, sir. What is the introduction, flow control, import, list of data structure, like complete material by default we are going to provide. Okay, sir, in today's session, whatever I covered up to this, even it is there in my material, sir. Have you observed language fundamentals? 31 pages, first topics are language fundamentals. Okay, like Python is a general purpose high level programming language. Python was developed by Guido, sir, like, but officially Python was made available, like, to print a hello world. Okay, this is the code we have to write. Next, and after that, you know, in C language, in Java, this is the code in C, like that, but in Python, how many lines of the code is required? Only one. Are you getting that? Okay, sir, like, same, to print a sum of two numbers, what is the code? Next, and after that, the name Python was selected from the TV show, okay, like, which was broadcasted in BBC from 1969 to 1974. Sir, Guido developed Python programming language by taking almost all programming features from different programming languages, like functional programming, object-oriented scripting, like all these things, right? Next, where we can use Python? Have you observed, right, for developing desktop applications we can use, web applications, database applications, network, games, data analysis, machine learning, like, sir, almost internally Google and YouTube uses Python coding, like, sir, all these things I explained very clearly. I hope, sir, like this, for every topic we are going to share the material, don't worry at all, sir. The material will be there, programs by default will be there, sir. Even if you are having any customizer also, most of the times we are going to discuss. Okay, that's all, sir. This is about from our side. Okay, if you are having any doubts, you can just let me stop the recording.